As Uganda anticipates commemorating the International Education Day on Thursday this week, the Ministry of Education and Sports boasts of the accelerated service delivery in the sector. Regardless of a number of bottlenecks in the sector, the State Minister for Higher Education, Dr. John Chrysostom Muyingo, has applauded the government for the progress thus far.
The increase in enrollment, especially through UPE, has significantly boosted primary school enrollment rates, allowing more children, particularly from low-income families, to access education. Following the introduction of UPE 1997, gross enrollment in primary schools has increased from 2.5 million in 1996 to over 8.6 million in 2023.
In the next financial year, 2024-2025, the Ministry of Education and Sports is looking forward to introducing compulsory universal primary education for all children in the school-going age, as the Director of Basic and Secondary Education at the Ministry, Ismail Mulindwa, explains.
Compulsory UPE is set to commence next year. Compulsory universal primary education is set to commence next year, and the capitation grant for primary learners, government has given us money to have that implemented. Over 300 billion Uganda shillings is planned to enable us to implement that compulsory universal primary education.
We have primary schools which are implementing UPE. And this is a government policy. If government says now we are going to complete UPE, compulsory UPE, we don't envisage a situation where the foundation bodies are going to oppose. After all, they have been implementing UPE.
The ministry has further revealed plans of rehabilitating several dilapidated UPE schools in the next financial year countrywide.
As government, we are proud and we are to announce that primary schools, many of our primary schools, will be rehabilitated in the coming financial year. Over 120 billion has been put aside to rehabilitate our primary schools, which is a significant step towards improving access. And of course, we are also going to construct 247 city schools.
This year's International Day of Education is themed on Learning for Lasting Peace. The celebrations will, however, be preceded by an exhibition on Wednesday this week at the Kololo Ceremonial Grounds, which aims at exploring the progress in the new lower secondary curriculum, initiatives in skilling and scholarship programs. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.